Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, elizafycreative. Today I am going to share with you how I turned this sketch that I created on my iPad using Procreate into this fun graphic using Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Firefly to get the end result. I'm so excited to share this with you, but before I get started, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. To start, I'm going to lay out the letters and just see how some of these layouts would fit well together that I have in my head. I like to do this when I have an idea in my head when it comes to letters because I love fitting letters together and creating typography like this. The fun size idea, it just came from a personal thing because I'm so short. I'm only 5 feet. So I just wanted to start sketching out these letters and create some fun bubble letters. This isn't supposed to be perfect because this is just a personal project, and yeah, I'm just wanting to have fun with it and enjoy the process. And once I'm done sketching out my ideas, I'm going to bring in a PNG file into Illustrator. I'm actually going to lower the opacity on the image so I can easily see what I'm drawing, but also see what I'm creating with the brush tool. So I'm going to lock that first layer and create a new layer. And then I'm going to click B on my keyboard or double click the brush tool and play with the sensitivity. And then I'm just going to loosely start drawing these letters. Like I said earlier, this doesn't have to be perfect. This is a personal project and it's just something I'm getting back into and having fun with. So while I'm creating these letters, I'm using the brush tool, the pencil tool, which is N on your keyboard, and the smooth tool. I'm then going to actually fill the letters with a black fill because I find that Adobe Firefly uses the contrast very well with the black and white. So I'm just going to save out the image as a JPEG, a high resolution JPEG, and then bring it and then open up Adobe Firefly. Once I open up Adobe Firefly, this screen comes up, so I'm just going to type whatever just so I can get to the next screen. And then on the left-hand side, under composition, I'm going to upload my image that I just created. So I'm going to do that. Once it's uploaded, a prompt box will come up and you just have to hit continue on it. It's just asking you if you have the rights to the images. And then I'm going to up the strength under the composition. And then the fun part starts. I get to write my prompt. With this one, I just wanted something fun and funky, so I just created something with pink and green because that's just what I was feeling. And then once I create my prompt, it will come up with these four options. And I'm actually liking this one the most, so I'm gonna hit download on this one. Then once it's downloaded, I'm going to bring it back into Illustrator because I need to resize it, because I'm actually going to print this for these frames I got on Amazon. So I'm gonna actually unbox these and take all the wrapper off for these frames. And I'm going to measure the mat because that's the size of the image I want to print that will fit perfectly in the frame. So this is the size. So I'm gonna go back to Illustrator and resize my image. Once my image is resized, I'm going to save this out as a PDF. And a high resolution PDF. You could have done this in Photoshop too, but I already had Illustrator open. So then I'm going to save this and I'm going to print it on my printer at home. But the printer paper I'm using is a glossy finish, like a photo paper finish, and I got it from Walmart. I'm printing on my Epson printer and I'm making sure my settings are for photo quality. And once I've set that up, I'm going to hit print. This is the paper. It has such a nice glossy finish. And then it will print like this. I'm going to cut off the final edges of the paper because I don't need that. Once it's all cut up, I'm going to put it back in my frame, put the frame back together. And I actually got these command strips from Amazon because I didn't want to keep asking my husband to put holes in the walls for nails. I just thought it was easier to do this. And then this is the wall I'm going to fill up with all my projects for this series. And yeah, I'm just gonna have a lot of fun with this project and I hope you follow along. That's the wall right behind me that I'm gonna fill up with all of these graphics that I create. I am so excited to share this project with you guys because I feel like I've been a little bit MIA in the graphic design world. And I'm just trying to get back into it and get motivated. So I'm excited for you guys to follow along and watch my process. I'm also really excited to fill my office with graphics that I've created. I've been wanting to do this for a while. So yeah, I'm so excited to share this with you. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one.